This is Duane Friend with University of Illinois Extension. If we did not have the benefit of sunlight, the Earth would be a cold, frozen mass. Almost all energy that we have or use on the Earth can be traced back to sunlight. How does energy from the sun heat the Earth? First, the sun must create the energy we call sunlight. This is done through a process called fusion. Because of the extreme heat and pressure found in the center of the sun, atoms of hydrogen are combined to form helium. It's estimated that 600 million tons of hydrogen are fused into 596 million tons of helium every second. 4 million tons of that mass is converted into energy. The output of energy, while varying slightly from year to year, is fairly constant. This energy takes a long time to work its way up to the sun's surface. Once it escapes, it travels in the form of many wavelengths of energy, most of it being invisible to our eyes. The energy travels at 186,000 miles per second. It takes a little over 8 minutes for sunlight to reach the Earth after it leaves the sun. Once reaching Earth, the more powerful and dangerous forms of sunlight are filtered and absorbed by the upper atmosphere. Most of the remaining wavelengths of sunlight travel through the atmosphere to get absorbed and to heat the Earth's surface. A small amount is absorbed by gases or reflected back to space. This helps explain why it gets cooler the higher you go in the atmosphere, because the Earth's atmosphere is mostly heated from the Earth's surface. The Earth re-emits this energy in the form of longer wavelengths. As this energy moves up through the atmosphere, some is absorbed by gases called greenhouse gases. These gases in turn re-emit the energy, with some being sent to space and some heading back to Earth's surface. This process keeps the energy in the lower atmosphere for a longer period of time, making the Earth warmer than it would be otherwise. This is called the natural greenhouse effect and keeps the Earth's average temperature around 59 degrees Fahrenheit. Eventually, all energy the Earth receives from the sun escapes back out into space. If this did not happen, the Earth would quickly become too hot for life to be present.